know, after all, they are also invented by some rishis. If you ask, Krishna says, never take Vedas as the inventions of human intellect. Because any invention of human intellect will have its own minus points. That is why one will do a research and get a PhD, and another will refute that theory and also get PhD. Rendu verku PhD kadachadu. It is very useful for PhD. Whereas you find the Vedic teaching not 100 years old. Many of our theories and all refuted within 10 years. And nowadays even 10 years are not required because research is going all over. That one theory is negated next moment. But Veda has withstood the test of time. We do not know whether it is 5,000 years old or 10,000 years old. Even now, Veda can stand the challenge of science. Even now, Veda can stand the challenge of science. If we find a defect in the Vedas, it is only because we do not know how to understand it. Simple coconut oil. Konja naalaki vandu ore criticism. Appra konja naalaki vandu coconut oil ore stuti. Ninda stuti. Ninda stuti. Ippa kadathile enakku enna confusion na ena Kerala la ellathum coconut oil dhaan. Idu confusion ana kadathile adu nallada kettada theriyave illa. Onnume pesuradhilla ippo. Similarly, tea, for some days they say it is bad. For some days they say it is very good. Theriyadhu. Alcohol. Adu edaila konja stuti panna solliyutta konja nalladhu nuta. Erkenave problem. Now they say that a little bit of alcohol is good, they say. So how do we know what is good for me, what is not good for me? So our tradition says, follow the Veda, nambinar keduvadillai. You will be wonderful. And therefore Krishna says, Brahma akshara samudbhavam. Veda is not the invention of human intellect. Veda has come out of aksharam. Aksharam means Bhagavan. Brahma means Veda. Very careful. Brahma means Veda and Akshara means Ishvara. Brahma Akshara Samudbhava means Veda has come out of the Lord. Then how come we say the rishis have given out the Vedas? You know the answer. I have told this before. Rishis have not invented the Vedas. Rishis have served as a medium for receiving the Vedic teaching, exactly like the television set. The television set does not produce the music. Music has been already transmitted elsewhere. The television set is serving only as a medium for the manifestation of this music. This is only a receiving set. Transmission is elsewhere. Thus, every rishi is like a television set. Every rishi is like a radio set. He has not invented, he has only served as a medium. Suppose if we ask Swamiji, why can't I be? Because when I close, I don't receive anything. I only get headache. I don't receive any mantra onnu varamatengirade. Remember, television set is specially prepared. Anything cannot receive. Similarly, we should also specially prepare ourselves by tapas, by dhyanam, etc. the rishis have prepared themselves. But what we say is, why should we become rishis? Already they are ready. They are cooked food irukra bodhe, fridge la ready made. Why should you go and cook again? So enjoy it. Similarly, we need not become rishis. They have already received it, and out of compassion they have brought down for our use. Therefore, let us study the Vedas and get the benefit of the teaching. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Lord Krishna is talking about the importance of Karma Yoga, looking at Karma Yoga from different angles. First, he looked at it as a commandment of the Lord Ishwara Ajna. Then he looked at it as a worship of the Lord Ishwara Yajnaha. Then he looked at it as a means of spiritual purification, chitta shodhakam. And now he is looking at the same karma yoga as dharmaha, a way of life which helps in maintaining the harmony of the creation. And Krishna talked about in the last sloka that everything is a cyclic process, and any cycle will be completed only when receiving from the world is followed by giving unto the world also. If I am only going to receive things from the world without giving importance to giving or sharing, naturally the cycle is incomplete. And once the cycle is not completed, then there is the violation of universal harmony. Then there is a stagnation which is not good for the physical health, the psychological health, the spiritual health, the economic health. At any level it is not good. Even from a simple angle of eating, we can easily understand this principle. If I am only going to consume food, then only taking take place, which means I am only receiving energy from the world, and proportionally if I am not ready to spend the energy or work, which they call exercise in some form or the other, again I am violating the natural cycle. I am physically consuming, but I am not giving. So imagine a person goes on eating 3 or 4 or 5 hours permanently throughout the day, and proportionately he does not work, then the cycle is broken, there is stagnation. And the stagnation alone comes in the form of fat or cholesterol or this and that. Then the doctor says, you park the car 1 kilometer away from the office and walk to the office. So you do some jogging or something or the other. Again, what is happening is, the doctor is talking about maintaining the harmony. And what is harmony? Proportionate to the food that I consume, I have to give out also. This can be extended at all levels with regard to knowledge also. If I am receiving knowledge,
then proportionately I should share my knowledge with others also. And that harmony is talked about swadhyaya pravachanecha. This is harmony at knowledge level. I receive knowledge, I have to give knowledge. And that is why in those days they threaten also, if you learn any science or art and you die without sharing that knowledge with anyone, then say, they will say, you will become a Brahma Rakshasa. For the papam that you have committed, and Brahma Rakshasa will be